In tonight's Military Matters, Fort Hood soldiers from various units continue helping Harvey victims in South Texas.
The soldiers are working around the clock distributing supplies. Channel 6 military reporter Jillian Angeline got an update on efforts earlier today and joins us now. Jillian.
Doug and Leslie, about 400 soldiers have completed a total of 89 missions so far, from rescues to handing over food and water, and the work continues.
18-hour days helping those who need it most. Fort Hood soldiers from the 13th ESC, 504th Military Intelligence Brigade, 11th Signal Brigade, 89th Military Police Brigade, 1st Medical Brigade, and 36th Engineer Brigade.
Our job is to relieve suffering and then basically to resupply as needed. And we've conducted air resupply of Class 1, which is food. We've done personnel recovery.
13th Expeditionary Sustainment Command Operations Officer Colonel Paul Martin Strzok also told Channel 6 troops have completed health and welfare checks on residents and route reconnaissance in light of the flooding on the move throughout devastated areas.
We've been in Katy, Orange, Beaumont, Liberty, and Warden, to name a few, but really all around those areas.
The mission has shifted focus from recovery to helping organizations like Red Cross and FEMA.
With the 100 trucks that we brought was to help them. So it's not our food, we're helping get it to the people that need it.
Colonel Strzok says despite the storm's devastating aftermath, the sense of community remains strong.
And already we've seen a lot of things kind of getting back to normal. I know it's not going to be that way for everybody. But, my heart goes out to those that have lost so much.
A native of Blanco, Texas, the colonel says it's the Texas pride that keeps everyone going.
People donating, people are helping out who have lost a lot themselves.
Now, I did hear about a scary moment for some of these soldiers when one of their vehicles sunk while driving in water. Officials say nobody was injured. They freed the vehicle and continued on their mission. But it shows it's still a dangerous situation in some parts of South Texas. Doug and Leslie, back to you.
All right, thanks, Jillian.